Hey Victory Kids, it's Miss Cheryl, and I'm so excited that today is week 4 of our summer road trip series. I can't believe we're almost halfway through our summer series. It's been so much fun going on this road trip with you. The first week, we did a quick drive-through meal. We talked about that and how the Passover was a very quick meal and that it should remind us every time we eat at a drive-through this summer on vacation. It should remind us that God has a plan for us. Week 2, we were at a rest stop, and that just reminds us that God always knows our needs. You know, a rest stop provides a lot of needs while we're on the road. Food, go to the bathroom, take a walk, get a drink. Just like the rest stop provides for our needs, God also provides for our needs. Last week, we learned about the Grand Canyon and how God is capable of doing the impossible. When God parted the Red Sea and the children of Israel walked across on dry ground. So I've been looking at all the pictures coming in to Facebook and my email, and I'm getting texts. Some of you are doing exactly what we're going to talk about today. So let's start with a word of prayer, and then we're going to talk about something that I really, really love to do. All right, let's pray. Father, thank you so much, Lord, that you take care of even the small things. There's nothing too small, Lord. If it matters to us, it matters to you, and we thank you for that. Help us to have a great summer road trip series, and I pray that the boys and girls would learn something in Jesus' name. Amen. So behind me, if you can see, there is a tent for camping. I love to camp. I have 2 boys and they love to camp. We used to go camping at the beach. We would put up a tent and we would have so much fun camping. So there's all kinds of different ways to camp. Pastor CT has this huge like motor coach. So when they camp, they get to have air conditioning. Isn't that cool? I don't have one of those, so I have to take a tent when I go camping. So no matter how you camp, I want you to know there are some really cool things about camping. You can connect with nature. You might could do some bird watching, go walk on the beach if you camp at the beach. Maybe if you camp in the mountains, you could go look for bears. So there's all kinds of things we could do fun camping. There's no internet, there's no TV, there's no air conditioning sometimes. So those are really cool things just to unplug and to get back to nature. It's fun, right? Well, the bad thing about camping is there's no air conditioning, there's no TV, there's no internet, no movies to watch. So there are some pros and cons to camping. If we're not careful, when we're on a camping trip like this, we can find ourselves complaining a lot. Speaking of complaining, the road trip in the Bible, these children of Israel were complaining. We're going to pick up the children of Israel's road trip in Exodus. Remember, Exodus is in the Old Testament. It is a book of history. And in chapter 16, here those children of Israel are complaining again. God just helped them so much by letting them cross over the Red Sea on dry ground. God was proving to the children of Israel that nothing is impossible with him. And yet we find just a couple chapters later, they're complaining again. Have you ever complained when you're in the car? Maybe you're on your way to grandma's house or Disney World, or maybe you're going to the Grand Canyon or to the beach to go camping. And this is sometimes what I hear in the car. Are we there yet? I'm so thirsty. I'm hungry. When are we going to be there? So I hear all that complaining sometimes. Really not anymore so much. But when my kids were younger, they would complain a lot. Just like my boys complained, the children of Israel were complaining. And this time, they were hungry. We learned a couple weeks ago that the children of Israel were thirsty, but this time they're hungry. And so this is what they said in chapter 16, verse 3. It says, "And the children of Israel said unto them, Would to God we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land of Egypt, when we sat by the flesh pots and when we did eat bread to the full. For ye have brought us forth into this wilderness to kill this whole assembly with hunger." They were so mad. They said, We should have just stayed in Egypt. At least there we had bread. And now you're going to kill the whole assembly, every single person, from hunger. And then the Lord said unto Moses, behold, I will rain bread from heaven for you. The people will go out and gather a certain rate every day, that I may prove to them whether they walk in my law or not. Now, this was the deal. God was going to provide for them even the small things, because God cares about what we care about. God, if it matters to you, it matters to God. God really does care about even the things that we find, the smallest problems that we have. My finger is hurting. I have a Band-Aid on it. I have a boo-boo underneath it. And guess what? God cares about it. He does, because it matters to me, and so it matters to him. And we can tell him even our smallest problems. And that's what the children of Israel, they were complaining, and Moses said, God, would you please just help us here? And God did. He cares about it because he cares about the children of Israel, just like he cares about us. So this is what God did. He rained this little white bread-like substance called manna, rained from heaven. So every morning, the children of Israel would get their baskets and they would go out and they would gather up however much they would need. And they would use this manna to make bread and to make food for them. God also provided quail. Now, quail is a type of bird, and it was something that they could eat and they could put over a fire and roast. And so God provided meat and he provided bread for the children of Israel. Now, here was the catch. They could not gather bread on the Sabbath. Remember, the Sabbath was a day of rest. So on day number 6, they had to gather 2 days worth. So they would gather for that day and for the Sabbath day, so that no work was done on the Sabbath. Now, they were only supposed to gather what they needed. If they gathered too much of the manna the next day, it would be rotted. In fact, I want to read it to you because it sounds disgusting. All right, it says this in verse 20. Notwithstanding, they hearkened not unto Moses, so they did not listen to Moses. Some of them left it, so they left the manna, until the morning, and it bred worms. So there were worms in it. Ugh, can you imagine? Ugh, go into the basket, and you open it, and there's worms in it. Oh, okay, and it stank. Whew. And it said, the Bible says Moses was wroth with them. Moses was very, very angry because they did not obey. So boys and girls, God will provide for us, but we still need to obey. We've got to obey, 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 obey. It's so very important that we obey. But today I want you to know that no matter how big your problem is or how small your problem is, God cares. He cares. He loves us and he cares. So the next time you go camping, I want you to remember about the time the children of Israel were camping in the wilderness and they were complaining. And maybe you'll start complaining when you're camping, like if it rains and your tent leaks or those nasty mosquitoes start to bite. There's so many things we could complain about while we're camping, just like the children of Israel were complaining about being hungry. But I want you to remember that God cares. And instead of complaining, let's be thankful and let's just ask him to help us with even our smallest problems, okay? All right, let's pray. Father, thank you so much for helping us with even our tiniest problems that may seem so small to us, but Lord, they are important to you. Thank you for that in Jesus' name. Amen. Bye, Victory Kids. Send your pictures of Flat Pastor CT. We're going to have a great photo album by the end of summer.